Vikram, I'm representing my team, Gavin Fellow, from Sri College of Engineering and Technology, Hyderabad. First of all, I thank SKDC for giving this opportunity to get into competitions and projects like this and improve our practical knowledge and develop our skills. And if you see our vehicle specifications, it is a vehicle of 70 inch and total vehicle width of our vehicle is 55 inch. And this is done according to by choosing our according to rule of constraint. We fixed our V base to 45 inch and V track to 35 inch. And this also shows the wrapping part of a vehicle, which is resembling the resembles a vehicle as a vehicle width and V base and V track. Coming to our material, chassis material, we have chosen with AISN 1018. And coming to the dimensions of it, it is 1 inch body and 3 mm thickness. And coming to the ground clearance of vehicle, we try to maintain 1 inch clearance from the ground. And coming to the braking part, we choose with hydraulic disc braking system. And coming to steering, it is a pitman arm. And this is an exploded go for vehicle, which shows that each and every component that we designed from nut and bolt. Next, coming to the critical selection for chassis, we choose with AISI 1018. On comparison with many materials like ASI 4130, 4140 and IS standard 1239, which is satisfying requirements through analysis and which is also very cheaper and also much available in our market, which is also having a good tensile strength of 440 MPa and a yield strength of 370 MPa. So we have gone with the material ASI 1018 with thickness of 3 mm and OD of 5 inch. And coming to our design methodology, we have done with the rough sketch, next we gone with the floor plan, and we made our driver seat on the floor plan. And for its comfortableness and the seating, and for the activation of our brake pedals, our accelerator pedals. Next, coming to the 2D design of our chassis, we have done in AutoCAD, and moving on to the 3D modeling of our chassis. And after the 3D modeling of our chassis, we again then aerobics to our chassis in Cadia and with the correct location of our brake pedals and the accelerator pedals with the seating location of driver. And this is a full assembled vehicle with our driver safety equipment. And coming to the main dimensions of our chassis, this is the total length of our chassis, it is 59 inch and the width is 29 inch. And through answers, we got our vehicle weight of 12 kgs. Sorry, the chassis weight has 12 kgs. Next will be continued by Mahesh.
Coming to analysis part, after the completion of design, the product must be analyzed in order to sell for manufacturing. In market, there are various types of software such as ANSYS HyperMesh. For our convenience, we have used ANSYS software. And coming to ANSYS, there are various types of analysis available for us, such as wind impact, rear impact, side impact, torsion, thermal analysis, etc. For our convenience in PPT, we have chosen four types of analysis that we have analyzed for our chassis. Coming to wind impact, on the application of load of 7.5G, we have obtained a total deformation of 0.67 mm. And coming to rear impact, on the application of load of 7.5G, the total deformation we have occurred is 0.13 mm. While calculating the maximum stress at the front impact, we have obtained a maximum stress of 285.6 MPa. For rear impact, we have obtained a stress of 138.6 MPa on the application of load of 7.5. Coming to next, side impact. On a load of 5G, we have obtained a maximum stress of 662.7 MPa and we have obtained a maximum deformation of 1.3 mm. Coming to torsion analysis, on the application of brakes, we have observed a vibration in the vehicle at rear axle. So we have applied a load of 43 Nm and obtained a maximum stress of 26 MPa. And we have obtained a negligible deformation of 0.02 mm, which is negligible. Coming to factor of safety. On analyzing the various types of analysis on our chassis, we can see that the factor of safety is more than enough, so that we can say that our design is appropriate and next further will be continued by Mr. President Bala.
Well, coming to ergonomics, ergonomics is the most important aspect for any vehicle. So it basically denotes the comfort and the safety of our driver who is in the vehicle. So we are actually providing a spacious cockpit in our car so that the driver feels comfortable and is confident on his driving. So we have actually followed the rules from the rule book, and we have given a minimum distance of 1 inch from the driver and the other accessible parts in the car. So as you can see, the integration of 95% men in comfort zone has been given in our car. There is a clear line of sight in the go kart, as you can see in this picture. We have also provided the kart with two pin switches, one which is provided at the steering wheel and the other at the engine for our crew members to access. All the parts in the kart are within the reach of the crew and the driver. We are also providing the driver with a complete driver's kit for his safety. We are also providing the cart with a fire extinguisher, and one fire extinguisher is with the crew members in case of emergency. Coming to innovation, we are actually planning to have a brake fluid sensor at the master cylinder so that we can avoid leakages from brake. We are also designing energy generation using exhaust gases from the exhaust. Next, coming to steering. So basically what steering means is it's a mechanism used to change the direction of a vehicle. So we are actually using Pitman now, which works on Ackermann steering principle. So the basic wheel drag is 35 inches and the wheel base is 45 inches. This is the sub-axle which we have designed in SolidWorks. So after many iterations, we have come to a conclusion that the inner turning radius is 1.6 meters. The outer turning radius is 2.67 meters. The maximum inner turning angle is 34.89 degrees. And the maximum outer turning angle is 24.53 degrees. So as you can see, we have built add-on software for the steering mechanism. And here you can see analysis on the sub-axle, which gives us a maximum deformation of 0.295 millimeters, which is very negligible. So that's it for the steering mechanism. Next will be continued by my friend Pramay.
Coming to the braking department, is braking system important for an automobile? Yes, it is important for an automobile because it works as a safety system. If we consider a driver applying the force on a pedal, it tends to have a contact between the wheel and the road surface. Then the vehicle tends to stop. And here, coming to the type of braking system which we are using here is the hydraulic disc brakes. To be more effective, we are using double disc. And this double disc is selected from the Apache RTR 180 of rear axle. Coming to the specifications, the outer diameter of the disc is 200 mm and the thickness is 6 mm. And coming to the height of center of gravity, the height of center of gravity from the ground is 6 inch and the brake fluid which we are using here is Godfrey fluid. And the stopping distance at 40 km/h is 2.43 and the stopping time is 0.44. And the maximum stopping distance is at 80 km/h is 9.73 and the stopping time is 0.87. Here we can see the disc which we have modeled in the SolidWorks, and we did thermal analysis on the disc and the reflex on the disc. Here we can see the COG location of the go-kart, and this is the pedal analysis, and this and it gave the maximum deformation of 0.18 mm. And next session will be continued by the Mr. Amit.
Now it's about transmission. Transmission is very important in any go-kart, and powertrain is all about how the energy is generated in the engine and how that energy is transmitted to the wheels with the help of rear axle and the chain. And in order to win a competition, we need to select a good engine, and that should comprise good displacement and maximum power and torque. But not to satisfy the rules, the displacement is given as 125cc. We make sure that we have short distance of engines which are under 125cc. You can see all the top hero igniter, and then comes the photo server, and then photo shine. And hero igniter has 11 bhp at 8000 rpm and 11 newton meter at 5000 rpm. And you can see the photo server. It will be approximately the same, but coming to top, it has about 6500 rpm. The only difference between igniter and Star is only this. But the availability of these Honda standard is only 70%. In order to get that engine, it is very critical sometimes. So we have gone through Hino igniter because the availability is very good. And you can see the diagrams over here, and you can see the muffler. And this is Hino igniter engine, which is running solid works. And that is the constituent of the muffler. And this one is made with ANSI software. And you can see how the heat is dissipation. The heat is dissipation takes place with the help of the color. And coming to gear ratios. And gear ratio can be calculated by taking the ratio of driven gear to the driving gear. And you can see over here, the gear ratio for the first gear will be 3.076 with Hino igniter. And using that, the maximum speed we get is 20 at first gear, and the maximum speed at the final gear will be 62.9 kmph, and the maximum acceleration is 6.3 meter per second square. And coming to the specifications of the engine of Hino igniter, it has got 5 gears, which is air cooled, and we made sure that our transmission will be manual, and it is air cooled and with wet multi-grade clutch. The reduction for primary is 3.35, and the calculations, the final reduction for about is 1.82. And this is all about the powertrain. In the next few slides will be continued by different star.
Coming to the fabrication, according to the facilities available in our company, 30 milling, drilling, grinding, lathe operation. In the lathe operation, we have both hubs for disc and sprockets, and this is the drilling machine which we run in our complex, the operation which we run in our next. Coming to the good insulation facilities in our complex, we can ourselves for pipe bending and other special operations like CNC machining. And coming to the estimated cost, the total estimated cost will be 58,000 and approximate page will be 82 pages. And coming to the pie chart, we have the 20% of the major cost incurs on the frame and body and safety equipment. And minimal cost incurs on the miscellaneous steering wheels. Next slide will be continued by Varun.
Coming to the point that we have given 187 days for e-road. We have made a team for 187 days. In that, we started working, we formed a team in 11 days by some special process. And later, we started working on the roadbook and studying the roadbook, and we took 12 days for filing our specifications. After finalizing the specification, our designing team started working on designing for 50 days, and they started modeling. In between, while working on the modeling, there is a workshop held in our college. And after attending the college, they have learned many things in the workshop, and we applied the learned things in the world, and we completed our designing, modeling, and answers part. And we are here in front of you with our design report. Later, we are showing the later on which we are going to do and how fast we are going to do. And I think we are going to complete the time prior to the event, 30 days prior to the event. By the end of December, our cart will be ready. Design validating plan. After designing, we should check how good our design is. So, we have assigned a team for validating the design. Here, we are showing how my team has done the validating part. Like if you take the tensile strength of pipe, we have tested the strength of the pipe on UTM machine for validating team member. Like in the mounting, we have seen that non-tensile 70% of energy should not be absorbed by any mounts. So we have done for accelerometer for checking the vibration. All the brake circuits, pin switches, firewalls, all been checked by our validating team. Next step. DFMA. Coming to DFMA, it is design failure overriding effect analysis. After manufacturing, at the time of if the car goes any damages or any errors, there is action taken to take the action that has been taken to rectify those mistakes. Here in this chart, we have given what the action taken at the time when there is any potential effects or any failures. And occurring severity detection is
rated according to the severity and then within an RPM value is calculated. The charges, the powertrain system or wedging, there is any leakage from or fuel leaking, the fuel lines are changed by my activity. And all the similarly, all the things are clearly shown in our chart. Which like we are showing the complete assembly for part of our gearing for nothing. Here the team with the division and team map of our team. That's it. This is our channel off.